So, okay, welcome back to our class. Now let us continue our class. Let us solve the remaining examples. Okay, see, we have solved two examples now here. This one is over. This one we were trying to solve. The spectator said, "Bravo, well played, Mohan." So I'll solve this one for you. So I'll solve this one for you. See, the spectators, said. So what are they doing here? Bravo. Okay, well played, Mohan. See, what is the meaning of bravo? If you find the word bravo, it means what, children? I have written here, no? See, bravo means what? Approval. Means they are all very happy that he had played well. So that's why they are approving him, no? So that is why you are using the reporting verb applauded here. Okay, so see this word applauded. The spectators applauded whom? Who did they approve? They applauded Mohan, no? The spectators applauded Mohan, saying that, okay, saying that he had played well. Okay, saying that he had played well. So in this way you have to change. The spectators applauded Mohan, saying that he had played well. So now the next one is somewhat same one. The captain said, "Bravo, you have done well, my friends. Go for this." Yes. Write the answer in your notebook for this question and tell me the answer. Yes, who has got the answer? Yes, I have one student with the answer. Yeah, Vaishnavi is there. Anudi, only two students. Aditya Egde. Aditya Egde, you try. Aditya, can you speak? Okay, so if Aditya has Sushrita, today I'll give the chance to Sushrita. Sushrita, tell me the answer.
The captain
applauded. The captain applauded. L-A-U-D-E-D. Applauded. Who did he applaud? The captain applauded
his friends.
Very good. His friends.
By saying.
Saying that.
They had.
Very good. They had done well. Very nice. Okay. Thank you. Your answer is correct, Sushrita. So, do you have any doubt about this one? Has anybody got doubt about this? Okay. No one has got doubt. Now, let us go for the next one. That is, how glad I am, said Anu, to meet my friend here. Solve this. Yes, who is ready with the answer? Yeah, I have Aryan. Then next, yes, Vaishnavi Aryan is ready. Then? Yes, again, only third student is Sushrita. Yeah, who will answer me? Only three students. Anudeep, will you try?
Mataji, can you give me 1 minute?
Yeah, I'll give you. Take your time and solve the question. Kritika got the answer. Okay. Yes, Diksha got the answer. Okay. Anudeep, did you get the answer?
Yes, Mataji.
Okay, tell the answer.
Anu exclaimed with joy.
Yes. Anu. Exclaimed. Anu exclaimed with joy. Okay. Anu exclaimed with joy.
That. She.
She
is glad to meet her friends.
See what you have to do. That time also you made the same mistake, Anudeep. She was glad. Only glad or before that glad adjective you need any adverb. She was very glad. She was very glad. Yes, now we are going in the correct way. So, Anu exclaimed with joy that she was very glad. Okay. Very glad.
To meet her.
Okay.
Friend there.
See. Okay. To meet her friend there. Your answer is correct now. So here, with joy, in the place of with joy, you can use surprise. Okay, with surprise is also okay because she didn't expect her friend there, no? So that's why. She is happy as well as she is surprised. So that's why you can even use surprise there. Okay. So now, anybody has got doubt regarding this? Yeah, if anybody has got doubt, then we'll solve. Yes, okay. So, everybody's doubt is clear, no? Nice, children. So, we have already solved 10 examples on exclamatory sentences. No, in case of exclamatory sentence. Okay, Purnachandra Hegde, which one you didn't understand? Purnachandra and Shravani have doubt. About what you have doubt, Mary?
Mataji, very glad to meet her friends there.
Very glad to meet her friend there. About this you have doubt. Shravani, what doubt you have?
Much last sentence.
Last sentence, okay, see. How glad I am. See, this one is given in inverted comma, no? How glad I am, said Anu. Okay? Said Anu. This is another part. Again, in the inverted comma, something is given. To meet my friend here. How the? So, this sentence, Anna, you can write in other way. Anu said, okay? How glad I am. To meet my friend here, in this way, you can write it, okay? How glad I am to meet my friend here. So this is the other way of writing this sentence. Now what you can do? So who told? Anu said no. Anu was very happy. Okay, that's why she exclaimed with joy. Okay, she exclaimed with joy that, okay, how glad I am. So this is exclamatory sentence, right? How glad I am. So if you have to convert it to assertive sentence, it becomes I am very glad. Okay, so now how glad I am became I am very glad. So now in the place of I, you have to use the pronoun she. Okay. Then in the place of am, you have to use its past tense was. She was very glad. Then next thing, see, to meet, my means her, no. To meet her friend, here should be changed into children, what? Her. To meet my friend here, I have here, no? So this here should be changed to they. Okay. So Anu exclaimed with joy that she was very happy to meet her friend they. Okay. Now Shravani, is your doubt clear or you need further explanation?
No, Mataji, doubt cleared.
Okay, very nice. Purnachandra Hegde.
Clear.
Okay, okay, good. Yes, children. See, so far we have discussed about direct and indirect speech in detail. No, we started with assertive sentence. We have discussed about interrogative. Then we have discussed about imperative sentence. And last, finally, we have completed our discussion with this exclamatory sentence. So, in the coming days, I'll give worksheets about these things. You see, in detail we have covered active voice and passive voice, and also we have covered direct and indirect speech, you know. So in the next grammar classes, in the coming grammar classes, I'll start with degrees of comparison. Okay, so if you have any doubt about this, or if you have any difficult question about this, you can send it to me. I'll give its answer, and also I'll send the worksheets for you. You have to work it out. Okay. Yes, after this, today I have told that I will ask you questions about the lesson collectors, the collectors. Hope you all have read the lesson. Hope you all have completed writing the question and answers of the lesson. Did you complete writing the question and answers? Raise your hands and tell me yes or no. You all have completed. Very nice. Okay, now in the lesson collectors, we have some what grammar activity there about suffixes and prefixes. So I'll give it as homework for you. Just open your textbook. Do you have the textbook there with you? If you don't have, get it. Children, see in page number 58. Okay. In page number 58, you have one activity about prefix and suffix, 58 and 59. So, what is prefix and what is a suffix, you know, no children? See, I'll write one example for you. Okay, see, you know, I have a word called force. Okay, now I have a word called force. And I am adding two letters before this force. It became enforce. So here what am I doing? I am adding the prefix and I made the new word. Okay. So force, enforce. It became a verb. Force, which was a noun, became a verb by adding en and by making that verb enforce. So this is called prefix. Then next one. So again, I will have the word force here. And for this, I will add this fully. Okay. So now force, which was the noun, became what children? Adverb. Forcefully. So here, I have added this fully. No. So this is what children? Suffix. This is prefix and this is suffix. I think you have all learnt about this thing in your previous classes. So in the textbook, they have given some activity on that. Okay. In page number 59, see, I will read out one. So 1BI, by, they have taken as a prefix. And what is the meaning of that by they have given? By means two or twice, no? Example, they have given, cycle was the original word. And by adding by to that one, bicycle, they got bicycle. So in this way, you have to prepare, you have to make the new word and you have to write it in the fourth column. So that you have to do, that is your homework. So this is prefix. Then come to next column there, next table. See, they have given suffix er, or, okay, I-S-T-E-E like that. And they have given examples. See, teacher. Teach, okay, teacher, teach, teacher, then edit, editor, okay, tourist, okay, tourist, IST, by adding IST to tour, it became tourist, then employ, okay, to employ, they added, employ is a verb, to that they have added EE, it became a noun there, employee, okay, see, like that, you have to change. Understood? So you can ask, Mataji, doctor, D-O-C-T-O-R, doctor. So here O-R is not the prefix. Whereas, see, teach, T-E-A-T-E-A-C-H, teach, it is a verb, no? For that, I am going to add this suffix, E-R. And now you got a new word there, teacher, okay. So, you have a word called tour. It is the word, it is the meaningful word and it is the original word. And for this, I will add IST. Now, you got new word by adding the suffix. Your new word is a tourist, okay. So, this is how you have to make new words. With the help of adding prefixes and suffixes, you can prepare or you can make new words there. You can change a noun to adverb, or else you can change a noun to what? Verb. So force was there, you made it enforce, no? You changed it to verb, right? So in this way, you can make new words, you complete that activity, page number 58, 59 and even in 60, okay. In page number 60, they have given one more activity, you complete that. If you have any doubt, let us discuss in our coming classes. Then, another activity they have given here, vocabulary activity, page number 58, children. Look at the following describing words. Describing words are nothing but your adjectives, no? Look at the following describing words and phrases. Group them under the words or phrases describing the place and describing the grounds. Write two different paragraphs, sorry. Write two different paragraphs describing the place and grounds. See here. They have given column A and column B and here they have given few words. So, write the words that describe the place here and write the words that describe the grounds here in this column. So, hope you have understood. You will complete that activity. Okay. Tomorrow we will continue our class. Thank you very much, children. Here we are going to end our today's class. Thank you.